Hello friends, welcome to second video of our video series Electrical Power Generation to Distribution. As we have discussed complete process in our first video, how the electrical power is generated by running alternators with the help of steam turbines. And finally, we come to the transformers to increase the voltage level of generated electrical power so that we can transmit it up to long distance. And as per Indian standards, the specified voltage limit for generation by 15 MW and above units is 11 kV or 13.8 kV or 16 kV depending on the size of units. And we can increase it up to a level of 66 kV, 132 kV, 220 kV or 400 kV depend on the length of the transmission line. Now the question is, why it is important to increase the voltage? And the answer is, by doing so, we can send it up to long distance. Also, it minimizes the losses. So what kind of losses? Heat losses. At low voltage side of transformer, the value of current is higher. So that side, it consists of conductor with higher cross-sectional area than high voltage side. Even though a quite high amount of heat is produced in the conductor of low voltage side, and in most of the big size power plant, the conductors from generator to the transformer is covered with oil jacket for frequent cooling. Otherwise, it could get melt. Suppose if voltage is not increased at power plant and the power generated is sent up to the consumer end, who are generally located far from the power generating plant. In that case, the complete conductor has to carry it inside the oil jacket and oil cooling arrangement will be required at regular interval. Even though a quite large amount of power will get waste in form of heat, which is not possible practically. So it is important that voltage must be increased to reduce the current so that heat loss also get reduced. Now, some of our viewers might be thinking how current could get decreased by increasing voltage. As per Ohm's law, the current must also increase with the increase in voltage. Dear viewers, don't get confused. In this case, electrical power is constant. As we know the relation, power is equals to VI cos phi. Taking power factor as a constant, it is in our hand, are we want to send power from one end to another end with a combination of higher voltage and low current or with the combination of low voltage and high current. As obvious, the best choice is higher voltage as much as possible. But friend, high voltage also poses some limits due to insulation problem. As much voltage level we increase, the more number of insulation disc and higher height of the tower is required to carry electrical conductor. However, electrical transformer are used to increase voltage level and to decrease the magnitude of current in transmission line circuit. Dear friends, let's have some more example to understand why it is important to increase voltage for long distance transmission. Like, as far as we want to send water in water supply system, the height of water tank must also be high. Here, in this illustration, the speed of water is representing electric current, while the pressure on the water due to height of water tank is representing the electrical voltage. As water is passing through this pipe, the water is facing friction from the inner surface of this pipe. If we increase the length of the pipe, then we will find that the pressure at this end will get decreased due to internal friction and we get low jet of water at this end. And as much we increase the length, we get as much low jet of water. If we have to maintain the jet of water, then we have to increase the height of the tank. Very similar concept is applicable to electrical system, where we want to maintain electric current at far end in electrical circuits, then voltage should also be increased. Friends, let's have one more example, and after seeing this example, you will get a complete understanding of why we increase the voltage for long distance transmission. Like here, we have a mechanical system consisting of a pulley which is rotating at high speed and driving another pulley through a belt, therefore transferring mechanical power from one point to another. Obviously, if pulley rotates at high speed, the belt also moves rapidly. This creates a lot of friction between belt and pulleys, and as a consequence, heat and sound are produced. That means the system will have more losses. So as we know, what is power in mechanical system, specifically in rotating system? It is given as power is equals to speed multiplied by torque. As in this system, the heat and sound is linked to the speed. So to reduce these losses, we must decrease the speed. But the condition is that the power must remain unchanged. So for that, we can do some modification in this. The two pulleys are replaced by two gears of same diameter and they will drive two gears of big diameter. Both these gears have been coupled by two pulleys and one belt. Because the pulley was rotating very fast and it has been replaced with gear, it also rotated very fast. But this gear will rotate at lower speed than this. Here in this example, there is a ratio of 10:100. So this gear has 10 teeth and it will rotate 10 times, then this gear will rotate 1 time because it has 100 teeth. And because these two gears are coupled and are of same diameter, both will rotate at same speed. So now the belt will not have to move at that high speed, which will reduce the friction significantly and will be reduced by 10 times. And here at this point, we get the same speed and torque because here we have opposite gear ratio. So here, the heat and sound losses in this system has reduced considerably because they will not be generated for free and will take energy from the system. So of course, the same concept applies in electrical system as well. If we want to reduce the losses, then the voltage has to increase. In the case of mechanical system, the belt thickness will have to be higher because the stretch on belt will be much higher. And here in the electrical system, if we increase the voltage, then we will have to increase the thickness and number of insulation discs because the voltage stress in the system will be much higher. Now suppose if we are increasing the voltage to 66 kV, 132 kV or 220 kV, then we do not need to use double conductor in each phase. But if we are increasing the voltage to 400 kV, which is known as HVAC system, then we must have double conductor per phase because at that much high voltage, the air around the conductor starts to ionize and it is called as corona loss. Transformers are equipped with surge arrestors that ground the voltage surge coming from the system to the transformer and prevent it from entering in the transformer. And they are connected in parallel. This means that one terminal is connected to the line conductor and the other terminal is grounded. So as soon as the voltage increases more than a limit, like this line is of 400 kV and voltage suddenly rises to 3 to 4 times. So this extra voltage will be earthed by surge arrestors. In many models, the surge arrestors are mounted on the transformer tank because the tank is also connected to the earth. After getting connected with surge arrestors, the output of transformers are connected to station bus called as generator bus. Here in this example, we are having a single three-phase transformer, whereas in previous video of this series, we have discussed that we can also make three-phase transformer by connecting three individual single-phase transformer. Usually, the power requirement from power generating plant is always high. So it is not possible for power plant to meet this demand with a single generator transformer unit. So most power plant have multiple generator transformer unit which generate large amount of electricity, and all unit must always be connected in parallel. Like here, we are seeing one more unit of transformer for which there should be also a generator inside the turbine room. So by this generator bus, all the units are connected in parallel and they are connected in same sequence. So like here, first R phase, then Y phase and then blue phase are connected. Similarly, for second unit, same sequence must be followed, like R phase, then Y phase and then B phase must be connected. After these conductor will go to the transmission line, but first they pass through circuit breaker, which work as a switch to make line on and off. There are isolators on both sides of circuit breaker which are used to isolate the breaker from system during maintenance. As gas filled circuit breaker, are used in high voltage systems, which often require gas refilling. To do that, first the circuit is closed and the isolators are opened, so that we are able to ensure that we are isolated from the system. Now, both the isolators and circuit breaker are opening the circuit, but what is the difference between them? Circuit breakers open the circuit in working condition or in condition of fault, while isolator cannot do so. The isolator can open the circuit only when current is not flowing in the circuit. Suppose if this circuit breaker is to be maintained, first we will close it so that the current becomes zero. Then we will open the isolator because even though current is not flowing in the circuit, but the voltage at the terminal will still be there. And we cannot suddenly stop large generators. It takes a lot of preparation. So now the current is zero in the circuit, we will open these isolators. When the rods of the isolator rotate in this way, the isolator opens and we get isolate from generator bus. Then we work on the circuit breaker. To measure how much current is flowing in the transmission line, current transformers are installed in each phase. So whatever current is flowing through this line will pass through this current transformer, and this transformer will reduce the current in the secondary circuit. Like if 1000 ampere current is flowing in the line, then 10 ampere current will be flowing in the secondary winding. We can measure the reduced current with the help of small ammeters of standard size. Such arresters are also installed near the circuit breaker and current transformer to protect them from voltage surge. After this arrangement, our conductor continues to the transmission line. As here, we have two generator transformer units, and here we have two circuits for transmission line to send the generated power. How much current is flowing through these lines? We measure it with the help of current transformer. But to measure voltage on these lines, we connect the voltage transformer to these buses. They are also connected in parallel like surge arresters. That is, one terminal of them is connected to the bus and other to the ground. So just as current transformer reduces current in secondary circuit, similarly, these transformers reduces the voltage in the secondary circuit to measure the voltage from small standard size voltmeter. So friends, we have understood the switchyard. Friends, the switchyard we have shown here, we made it very simple, but the actual switchyards are usually a bit complicated and consist of more equipment. We will introduce more equipment as we proceed further in this video series. So now, let's end this video, and I hope you like this video. Friends, if your answer is yes, press the like button, share it, and new viewers who haven't subscribed our channel yet, please subscribe so that you will get notification of our upcoming video. At last, thank you friends for watching the video till the end.